वायरस हैज सिक्स जीनोटाइप्स, जीनोटाइप 1 to 6। इन आवर कंट्री वी नो जीनो 1 एंड जीनो 3 आर वेरी मच प्रेवलेंट। हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम डॉक्टर सार्थक मलिक। currently I am working as a consultant gastroenterologist in Fortis Escorts Hospital, Okhla, New Delhi. Today I will be summarizing a very important topic of chronic hepatitis C, which is important for your upcoming super speciality exam, gastroenterology. So chronic hepatitis C, we have already discussed in a lecture on in great detail. Today I will be summarizing the whole topic in a short while. So it is a single-stranded enveloped RNA virus, and the life cycle begins by host entry. It uses two important proteins for entry into the host, that is the E1 and the E2 protein, which are the envelope protein on the surface and which attach to the hepatocytes. So after it enters the hepatocyte, it uses the host machinery and synthesizes a lot of proteins. We know that all the proteins are divided into two types. One are the structural proteins and other are the non-structural proteins. The structural proteins which are formed by the virus include the nucleocapsid P21, the E1 and the E2 proteins, and the non-structural proteins are various NS1, NS3, NS4, NS5A, 5B, which we have discussed in detail in our class. Now, virus has six genotypes, genotype 1 to 6. In our country, we know geno 1 and geno 3 are very much prevalent. Different geographic areas have different genotypes, and definitely genotype affects the management. What is the genotype of the virus? Now, how is the hepatitis C virus transmitted? See, the most important mechanism of transmission is the percutaneous route. That is, the IV drug abusers have a very high percentage of viral, like 57 to 90% of the IV drug abusers contract hepatitis C infection from the other drug abusers who have the infection. Also, needle stick injuries is an important route through which the virus gets transmitted. Then patients who are on chronic hemodialysis have a risk of getting infected. The other route of transmission is the perinatal transmission. We know that the hepatitis C can get transmitted through perinatal route, but the incidence is less than chronic hepatitis B. Similarly, sexual route, although very rare, can be a mode of transmission. However, it is a very rare mode of transmission for transmission of chronic hepatitis C. Now, coming in brief about the pathogenesis, if we see anybody who contracts hepatitis C, there is 50 to 90% chance that the acute infection will turn into chronic hepatitis C. Generally, this acute hepatitis C is clinically, it is asymptomatic presentation, patient do not have any symptoms, and generally they are picked up on routine blood test when they undergo routine blood test for evaluation of chronic hepatitis C. Now, if you see, there are many extra hepatic manifestations of chronic hepatitis C. Apart from the hepatic manifestation in form of hepatitis, they can lead to chronic liver disease, which can present with and ultimately transform to cirrhosis and its complication like ascites, variceal bleed, hepatic encephalopathy, and even hepatocellular carcinomas. These are the hepatic manifestations of chronic hepatitis C. The non-hepatic or the extra-hepatic manifestations of chronic hepatitis C include various manifestations, like patients can present with essential mixed cryoglobulinemia, because many patients have cryoglobulins in their serum, and they can cause various even kidney damage in form of glomerular disease. Then patient can have monoclonal gammopathy, patients can present with porphyria cutanea tarda, patient can have autoimmune thyroiditis, lichen planus, and cryoglobulinemic nephropathy. These are the various extrahepatic manifestations of chronic hepatitis C. Now, I will be summarizing the extensive treatment of chronic hepatitis C in a short time. Very important points which we have to remember is, every patient of chronic hepatitis C needs to be treated. Patients have the goal of treatment is to achieve SVR, that is sustained virological response. There are two types of SVR. One is SVR 12, that means a sustained virological response which is maintained at 12 weeks after treatment gets over, and SVR 24 is sustained virological response which is maintained 24 weeks after treatment is over. That is, after the end of treatment, patient has undetectable HCV RNA in the body. So, this is the sustained virological response. And then, what are the drugs we have? I will be summarizing. I have in detail talked about all the drugs which are available world over and which are part of the recent guidelines. However, in India, what we use, I will mention that in this with this video today. So we have sofosbuvir, which is the backbone of treatment. It is available in a dose of 400 milligram. We have velpatasvir, which is a pangenotypic drug, in a dose of 100 milligram. We have ledipasvir, which is in a dose of 90 milligram. And we have a drug that is ribavirin, which is available in our country. So sofosbuvir, Velpatasvir, ribavirin and ledipasvir. These are the four drugs available in our country. There is a new upcoming drug, that is volixaprevir, which is also in a dose of 100 milligram, and it is used in combination of sofosbuvir and velpatasvir. So now I will be mentioning what drugs we used and what duration for various genotypes. Okay, so you have to remember this point, that in all the treatment which I will mention for genotypes is to be given for 12 weeks of therapy. Within 12 weeks, patient gets cured. Most of the patients have an undetectable RNA. So now there are two types of patient. One is treatment naive patient, that is, who has not received any medication for viral hepatitis C before. One is the treatment experienced patient. See, hepatitis C is a long-term disease. Patient must be having disease for many years. But in the last 5 years, there has been a revolution in the management of hepatitis C by the availability of oral drugs. Before that, patients were treated with interferons, which are pegylated interferon and ribavirin. Slowly, the protease inhibitors came, but then they were removed from the market after the coming up of sofosbuvir and then the recent coming of velpatasvir. So that is why there are two groups of treatment. One is treatment naive patients and the other group is treatment experienced patients who have experience with previous therapies. Then treatment also depends on the stage of disease. We know that the fibrosis is graded as F1, F2, F3 and F4. F4 fibrosis means patient has cirrhosis. So patients who have F4 fibrosis have a different management compared to those who have F1 or F2 fibrosis, which is early stage disease. So now for genotype 1, patients who are treatment naive, we give sofosbuvir plus ledipasvir combination, or we can use sofosbuvir and velpatasvir combination for 12 weeks. This is enough for these patients of genotype 1. However, patients who have received past directly acting agents except NS5A, in these patients, if the patient has genotype 1A, then we can give sofosbuvir plus velpatasvir plus volixaprevir combination for 12 weeks. However, for genotype 1B, we can give sofosbuvir and velpatasvir alone for 12 weeks. Patients who have experienced with genotype with NS5A inhibitors, the only therapy we can give is sofosbuvir plus velpatasvir plus volixaprevir combination for 12 weeks. So this summarizes treatment for Geno 1, which is in India, we don't have volixaprevir, so we can use the combination of sof and velpatasvir in our country. Now, genotype 2, if the patient is treatment naive, then we can give sofosbuvir and velpatasvir for 12 weeks. However, if the patient is having experience with NS5A inhibitors in the past, then we have to give combination of sofosbuvir plus velpatasvir plus volixaprevir for 12 weeks. Genotype 3, this is a very problematic genotype, and its management is quite complex, because this is a resistant genotype. Drugs don't act well in this genotype, so we have to be very careful. Generally, it is recommended, if available, we have to do a mutation analysis of the RNA of the virus, and if there is Y93H resistance associated sequence, RAS, Y93RS sequence in the genome, if it is present or absent, this will decide the treatment. How? I will tell you. So if the patient is treatment naive and this mutation is not present, we can just give this patient sofosbuvir and valpartusvir combination for 12 weeks. But if this RAS mutation is present, then patient who have F4 fibrosis, that is who have cirrhosis, need to be given the combination of either sofosbuvir plus valpartusvir plus folixaprevir, which is not available in our country. So, but that is the ideal guideline for 12 weeks. But in our country, we can give a combination of sofosbuvir plus valpartusvir plus ribavirin in weight-based dosing for 12 weeks. This is the treatment for treatment-naive patient. For treatment-experienced patient, there are three categories of treatment-experienced patients in genotype 3. First is those who have received ribavirin in the past, they should receive combination of sofosbuvir, valpartusvir and volixaprevir for 12 weeks. Those who have experienced directly antiagarant in the past apart from NS5A should receive sofosbuvir, volixaprevir and valpartusvir combination for 12 weeks, but only up till F3 stage. Those who have received NS5A inhibitor in the past as treatment experience, they have to given four drugs, that is sofosbuvir, valpartusvir, volixaprevir and ribavirin, all four to be given for 12 weeks for these patients. Very important point. For Geno 4, the treatment is like Geno 1. Treatment naive patients can be given sofosbuvir plus valpartusvir or sofosbuvir plus ledipasvir for 12 weeks. Those who have received in the treatment in the past with pegylated interferon and ribavirin, then they can be given sofosbuvir or valpartusvir, but sofledi can be given only up till F3 stage in these patients. If they have F4 fibrosis and they have received pegylated interferon in the past, then they have to be given a combination of sofosbuvir, ledipasvir and ribavirin for 12 weeks. Then those who have received DA in the past, then we have to give the combination of sof, valpa and valixaprevir. Now for Geno 5 and Geno 6, if the patient is treatment naive or he is experienced with pegylated interferon experience, then we need to give either sofosbuvir or valpartusvir or sofosbuvir plus ledipasvir for 12 weeks. But if the patient is DA experienced with 5A NS5A inhibitor, then we have to add valixaprevir. So sof plus valpa and valixaprevir. Now, this was the summary of treatment of all the genotypes. So by this short video, I have mentioned all the important points and treatment in management of chronic hepatitis C. Thank you.